In this video, which is a part of series of videos on lipid transport, we are going to talk about reverse cholesterol transport. By reverse cholesterol transport, we mean that transport of cholesterol from extrahepatic tissues back to the liver. And the main lipoprotein involved in reverse cholesterol transport is HDL, the high density lipoprotein. So let's talk about reverse cholesterol transport. HDL is secreted from two tissues, the liver and the intestines. So let's say in the circulation, HDL is released either from the liver or from the intestine or both. The secreted HDL looks like a disc. So we call it discoidal HDL. It contains phospholipids, cholesterol, an enzyme known as LCAT, and its activator apolipoprotein A1. Now let's talk about this enzyme LCAT. LCAT stands for lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase. The name itself suggests that this enzyme will transfer an acyl group from lecithin, which is a phospholipid, to cholesterol. Now let's assume that this is a tissue. This is a tissue and it contains cholesterol. Now through two receptors, SRB1 and ABCG1. SRB1 stands for scavenger receptor B1 and ABCG1 stands for ATP binding cassette transporter G1. Through these two receptors, cholesterol is effluxed from the cells or the tissues. Now, at the surface of this discoidal HDL, the enzyme lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase catalyzes a reaction in which the hydroxyl group of cholesterol effluxed from the tissues and the carboxyl group of the fatty acid taken from the phospholipid reacts, and the reaction is catalyzed by lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase, and they are joined by an ester bond. So this becomes like this, an ester bond, and now it will be known as cholesteryl ester. Now this cholesteryl ester, being non-polar, from the surface of the discoidal HDL enters into the core of the discoidal HDL. So this process continues and more of cholesterol is being converted to cholesteryl ester, which enters from the surface to the core. Now the cholesterol is taken from the tissues, the phospholipid from the surface, there is a reaction, and the cholesteryl ester form is taken inside the core of the discoidal HDL. As this thing goes on and on, the discoidal HDL takes in more and more of cholesteryl ester, and after a period of time, the shape of the discoidal HDL changes and it becomes spherical, and then it is known as HDL 3. So discoidal HDL is converted to HDL3. Now again the same process continues, and then this HDL3 accumulates more and more of cholesterol from the tissues. More and more cholesterol from the tissues is taken and is converted to cholesterol ester by the enzyme lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase in the discoidal HDL, which enters the core of the HDL lipoprotein, and the size of the HDL lipoprotein increases and the density decreases, and therefore it is now known as HDL2. Now this HDL2 through a receptor on the liver known as SRB1, scavenger receptor B1, you must be realizing that the scavenger receptor B1 has got a dual role. In the tissues, it helps in efflux of cholesterol from the tissues to the HDL particle, while in the liver, it helps in transport of cholesterol ester from the HDL particle inside the liver. So this cholesterol ester enters inside the liver, where inside the liver, the cholesterol is secreted in via bile. Now another thing which can happen is that this HDL2 can be taken whole inside the liver, and there it can be catabolized by endothelial lipases and hepatic lipases. There are two lipases which can catabolize the HDL2, the endothelial and hepatic lipases. During the catabolism, the ApoA1, which this HDL2 contains, is released. This ApoA1 is released in the plasma. ApoA1 is released in the plasma. Now this is interesting. After associating with certain amount of phospholipid and cholesterol, this ApoA1 is known as pre-beta HDL. Pre-beta HDL is the most potent form of HDL. Most potent. Most potent. This pre-beta HDL, after taking some amount of cholesterol from the tissues through another receptor which is known as ABCA1. Through this receptor, cholesterol is effluxed and it reaches the pre-beta HDL, and then this pre-beta HDL is converted to discoidal HDL. So this is the thing. Now one thing, when this cholesterol ester from this HDL2 is selectively, only the cholesterol ester is selectively transported inside the liver through SRB1, this HDL2 is converted to HDL3. So there is another process which keeps on going. HDL3 takes more and more of cholesterol, which is converted to cholesterol ester, which goes inside the core, and then this cholesterol ester is selectively transported inside the liver through the SRB1 receptor, and then this HDL2 again is known as HDL3, and this cycle goes on and on. So this is known as HDL cycle. Now I will repeat the whole process again. In reverse cholesterol transport, cholesterol is transported from the peripheral tissue, extrahepatic tissues to the liver. However, the HDL is at first secreted either from the liver or the intestine. And initially it is known as discoidal HDL because it looks like a disc. and it contains phospholipid and cholesterol, an enzyme known as lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase, and its activator ApoA1. Now, this lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase helps in conversion of the cholesterol, which was effluxed from the tissue, to cholesterol ester, which the discoidal STL took inside the core, and this process continued. After a certain period of time, the discoidal SDL becomes spherical, and then it is known as SDL3. The same accumulation of cholesterol ester inside the core continues, and then this is SDL3 is known as SDL2. After that, the cholesterol ester is selectively taken by the SRB1 receptor through the SRB1 receptor inside the liver, where the cholesterol is excreted in the bile, and when this SDL2 loses cholesterol ester, it becomes again converted to SDL3, and the cycle continues. This cycle is known as SDL cycle. However, another fate of SDL2 is that it can be taken whole inside the liver and then can be catabolized by endothelial lipase or the hepatic lipase. The ApoA1, which remains, is released inside the plasma, where after associating with certain amount of phospholipid and cholesterol, it is known as pre-beta-SDL. Pre-beta-SDL is the most potent form of SDL, which takes some amount of cholesterol through another receptor, ATP binding cassette transporter A1, and then is converted to discoidal SDL, and the cycle continues. Now, regarding in context of the clinical significance, the concentration of SDL in plasma is inversely proportional to atherosclerosis, and that is clear because if you have more SDL in plasma, more and more of cholesterol will be converted to cholesterol ester, which will be transported to the liver.